Fellow St. Lucians, workers, employers, and you the wider citizenry, good day. I am truly honored once again as Minister with the responsibility for labor relations to address you on the observance of International Labor Day. The occasion is one observed the world over by the international labor movement and sanctioned by the International Labor Organization, the ILO. This year, Labor Day is observed under the theme Uniting Workers for Social and Economic Advancement. It is a theme that is rich in meaning, relevance, and significance, and one that reinforces the absolute mandate of the labor movement throughout the world. It gives value to the advancements attained by trade unions and labor organizations and underscores the need to strengthen our resolve for social justice. It is all too common for society to relegate of ordinary value the contributions of workers and the strides made by trade unions and labor organizations in strengthening laws and elevating social and economic standards of workers. These achievements have certainly contributed to the overall national development of our country. Landmark decisions and legislative changes are the bountiful harvest of the sweat, tears, and even blood of our forefathers in the labor movement. The selfless pursuit of humane standards motivated governments to respond by legislating laws that were fair and promoted the welfare of workers, influencing legislation with a human face rather than a heart of exploitation. They persevered to promote legislation that recognized that people were absolutely indispensable to the production process and the accumulation of wealth. The heightened significance that was given then is well appreciated as it attempted to elevate and give recognition and significance to workers. Through their engagement, workers steadily earned their rightful places in the enterprises. Their unions were fearful and proved unabated in their negotiating postures, and the doctrine of strength in unity was espoused by their membership who, with religious fervor, followed and supported the every move of their union leaders, even government took heed. Being fully aware of the progress made by the labor movement in St. Lucia and its contribution to the advancement of our workers, both at the workplace and in our society, it has always been my belief that labor-related matters should never be taken for granted, and we ought to recognize the role they play in nation-building, stability, and tranquility. We must never cease to celebrate the strides and advances made in the lives of the hard-working men and women in our country. Let us not lose sight of the efforts of our forefathers as we celebrate the strength, achievements, and esprit de corps, that sense of unity and of common interests and responsibilities as developed among our workers, trade unions, and labor organizations. The progress and strides made by the labor movement here in St. Lucia must always be at the fore and core of our collective consciousness. We must of necessity focus on our achievements and, more importantly, aim to build on that foundation. Never should we lose sight of opportunities to make further advancements. Any oblivion on our part may result in a potential loss of ground, underscoring the need to zealously guard those advantages. The Department of Labor commemorates this year's celebration with activities that emphasize the spiritual, economic, social, and civic significance of this prominent day of observance. Let today be an opportunity for introspection as workers, employers, and as a nation, one in which we must challenge ourselves by tracing our history, assessing our achievements, and mapping out a revised route on the way forward. Our role and function as stakeholders must be reassessed to determine what brand of employer or employee we are and the classification of a nation we are building. In so doing, there must be a re-evaluation and a recommitment to the cause for which our forefathers struggled so hard to institute to ensure the preservation of our civility. As minister, it is my intention to continue working collaboratively with all stakeholders to ensure that the mandate of the Department of Labor, enshrined in its mission statement, is fulfilled as we recommit to social and economic advancement. This year, the department will continue to work on concluding the review of the Labor Code in preparation for consideration by the Parliament, initiating the mechanism for instituting a tripartite arrangement to engender a stable and conducive industrial climate, implementing the recommendations of the management audit, which was conducted last year, and develop a strategic plan for the department with an appropriate structure to effectively execute the mandate of the department. And finally, the full development of the labor market information system to facilitate the role of the Department of Labor as a provider of information on the labor market. These initiatives are intended to reinforce the legislative framework which governs industrial relations in St. Lucia in an attempt to safeguard and strengthen the gains won by workers through the trade union movement over the decades. Also, the intention is to enhance the institutional, administrative, and social architecture necessary for a favorable industrial climate. I am confident that these targets can be achieved if only we, as stakeholders, can put our shoulders to the wheel and garner the willpower necessary to fulfill such national outcomes. On behalf of the government of St. Lucia, I wish to take this opportunity to extend warmest greetings to each and every worker and employer on the occasion of the observance of your day, Labor Day. Your individual contribution to the growth and development of your country over the years has been quite significant, a contribution that words are not enough to adequately express the deep sense of appreciation and gratitude that we feel towards all of you at this time. On my own behalf, I give you, the workers and employers of this country, the assurance that my team at the Department of Labor will work assiduously to ensure that your rights, entitlements, and safeguards guaranteed within the Labor Act are respected and implemented both at the workplace and in the country generally. Please accept my sincere thanks, and may God continue to bless you and your family with His wonderful love, good health, success, and prosperity. I thank you.